And that was one of the things that I focused on as it relates to the price of diesel and gasoline at the pump.
Mm-hmm.
As you know, that is it has a very serious impact, not only on consumers and households, but on businesses as well, small businesses and so forth. If you imagine a small business, but actually today I got a call and the guy tells me that he has a business that he purchases $5,000 worth of diesel a week.
Wow.
A 10% reduction on that could give him $500 to help pay his wages and keep people employed. So something as simple as those fluctuations in the pricing, as small as it may seem in terms of 3 cents, 4 cents, 10 cents, yeah, et cetera, they have a huge impact on individuals who are filling up their tanks to go to work, who are running around with their kids to do sporting activities and do lessons and go shopping and, you know, just family time, just to even have a drive in the country a Sunday evening, you know? So it has a huge impact. But I raised a question during the budgeting process, and as is the norm, the government ignored, because for them, if you are not kicking up a big storm and if Marcia Reeks and her team is not getting all bad about issues, they let them slide, you know? But I thought it was time enough now, leading up to a year, that I would raise it publicly.
Yeah.
And not only raise it, but put some substance on it so that Barbados get a real context of what I'm referring to. And normally the discussion when it comes to prices, the pump, is why is the price so high when compared to other jurisdictions? Yeah. We're not having that type of discussion here. We are saying to the government of Barbados that we have grown accustomed and we have been told for years that the price of oil, or the price at the pump that we pay at the pump, is heavily impacted by what is happening in the global environment. Once you hear that there's a global crisis of some form, whether it's war or anything like that, they come, the same minister comes to the media, he says, brace yourself.
Yes.
Brace yourself, we have to pay more for gas. We have grown accustomed that when that happens, when the spikes happen, the price goes up. Mm-hmm. But when the price starts to come down, the price also comes down, and we get an ease in the price.
Mm-hmm.
What we have seen in the last 12 months approaching is that there have been no reduction in price.
No reduction in the price, and you're saying there have been fluctuations on the global market.
Yes, there have been. And we could look at some of the graphs that I did.
You want us to do some of the graphs now?
Yeah, not yet.
Okay.
When we get to the graphs, we are saying, do not nitpick at a number. In other words, we've used an average price per barrel.
Yes.
Per month. It could be $85, it could be $90, $87, $86, and 40 cents. It is the concept of the fluctuation of the prices that we are concerned with.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And we'll show you two graphs which shows up pre-September 2023. There was movement in the price at the pump, and that kind of correlated to the movement on the international market of the price of oil.
Makes sense.
And then when we look at the post-September 2023, we will see what the result is. But we have grown accustomed to prices changing on the first Sunday of every month. And we refer that is based on negotiated prices with suppliers, which are influenced by shipping and freight rates as well. And again, which is as a result of any international crisis that might impact the territories that produce oil, et cetera. In some cases, Marcy, we know that there's no change. In other cases, there have been 2 cents movement in terms of increase, 5 cents decrease. Sometimes, as I said, it's constant.
Yes.
But these prices have stabilized at a very high price as well.
Mm-hmm.
When the price was at $4.22 per liter, and let's focus on gasoline.
Yes.
And that is over the last 2 years, I think from 2022, I think that is the second or third highest price that consumers were asked to pay at the pump. The highest, I think, went to around $4.70. And that was when the price of a barrel of oil on the international market was over $100.
Okay.
That price is not on over $100 now, but we've seen it gradually come down and we've seen the fluctuations over time. So if you pull up the first graph, which you just
first graph. Here, so we're gonna look now at the first graph.
Yeah, let's share that one.
Yes. While we're doing that, people, make sure that you're sharing and that you're liking, right? This is very important for us people. Yeah. Share and like. It's coming up right now, yes.
Right. So you might not be able to read all of the numbers and all that, but essentially, let me just walk you through it. Essentially, what you have, we have two lines here, two lines as a line graph. We have a green and a blue. The green represents, which is the one belief lower, represents the movement in the price per barrel in US dollars.
Yes.
The blue line, which is above, represents the movement in the price per liter at the pump in Barbados.
Wow. And
we've chosen a price range, date range, July 2022 to September 2023.
Yes.
So, you know, just about 14 months or so. Now, you can see that the graphs are behaving in a similar manner. Mm-hmm. Not fully, but you can see it started with a price when the price of a barrel of oil was over $110 US. You see the price there at $472. And as it drops, mm-hmm. you see the price. We see in the first 3 or 4 months, we see the drop as well, the correlation of the drop of the price at the pump in Barbados.
Yes.
And if you follow the graph, you will see kind of the curve kind of following it. It's not consistent.
Yeah.
And there are probably justifiable reasons for it. I went not that. But as I said, the point here is to get across to you and to the listeners and viewers that there has been movement in correlation to that price.
Yes.
And generally that has been every month. There are some situations where there are price changes in 2 months, in November 2022. Mm-hmm. And they had that plotted there. You can't see it from the screen, but that is there. So it is not that we are on a witch hunt. It is that we are saying to the government that pre-2023,
yeah.
there have been changes that have correlated to what we have been told and what we've become accustomed to when it comes to the price at the pump that we pay.
Yes. Now,
if you go to the second graph, and this is post-September 2023, for the last 11 months, you see a continuation of that movement and fluctuation on the international market.
Wow.
What you see is a drastic decline in December of the price going to, I think, December, January, $77 a barrel, versus $93 a barrel approximately on average in September. And then you see a gradual increase again up till about March or so, and then uh-huh. a decline again down to July.
Yes.
But again, without focusing on the exact dollar per barrel, you see the concept of movement on the market. But when you focus on our price at the pump, you see no correlation at all.
So, Senator Walters, let me just pause again because this is like school. So let's just pause so that everybody understands. So the blue line, that is our price in Barbados over the almost 1 year period. And the yes. green light is what's happening globally. We're seeing the fluctuations globally of the price of petrol. However, we're looking at the blue line right there. If we could just put the cursor on that blue line and you're seeing it, that it's constant. Am I correct, Senator Walters?
Correct. Constant wow. for 11 months. Yeah.
But I want to hear, viewers, you see this? Look, this is so clear, right? This is so clear. I want to hear your thoughts on this, viewers. Write in the comment section. What are your thoughts? If Dave could show them, should we show them again 2023, yes, Senator Walters? Yeah. Let's look at 2023. Look at what was happening in 2023. You notice the blue line was behaving, in the same way as the green line. The green is what's happening on the global market, and the blue, it's the petrol prices in Barbados, and they were behaving very much alike. Do you see that? Everybody, take a screenshot. Take a screenshot. We came on here to be educated tonight. We're being educated tonight, okay? And this is so important. We want to thank Senator Walters for this. Take a screenshot. And now let's go, Dave, to the next graph, which is, yes. So this is our current situation, right, Senator Walters?
Correct. This is from September onwards to July of this year. So you see that we are not seeing that movement that we've seen in the last slide correlating with the movement on the international market. We should have seen a significant dip
yes.
at some point in 4 months on December, January. We should have gotten some relief. And although we would have climbed back up, you know, we would not have climbed back to the same level that we were in September either. So we would always be below. And this peak down to the bottom here, put your cursor on the 77, right? That is about 17% reduction in the price when compared
wow.
to September.
So look how that dipped. Look how that dipped.
Now, again, as I said, we don't want to get into the, because if you're nitpicking somebody that supports the government, because this is not a governmental, we are not on a witch hunt here. This is hardcore facts. This is a genuine concern that we have. It is a genuine concern and should be taken like that. So we are looking at the trend. And if we are following a trend as we did previously, we should have seen a reduction along this straight line. That should be, that if we were in Kwapoba, that should be walking up, as we would say. That should be moving. That should be moving, Marcia. With the graph that the movement on the international market. So really, that is the bone of contention. We are not here to say, oh, the government is taking too much money in taxes on the gasoline, on those stories. We're not here to say, why is it that in other territories they are paying less? We are saying to the government, you have control over this. This is regulated. This is a price control scenario. And it is a price control based on certain circumstances, and you have no. It looks as though you have changed the way how you respond to the circumstances in which the price of at the pump is charged to consumers in Barbados. And we really need answers. We really need answers.